Next, I'd like to talk about the incidence and prevalence of dementia as it relates to the South Asian population residing in the US. So, unfortunately, there are no current studies in the US depicting dementia prevalence for the South Asian population specifically. There are a few studies in the UK, and what I'll really turn to is actually worldwide studies that are dementia prevalence in India, because that's the best data we have. The table that you see on the slide shows that using a DSM-4 diagnosis of dementia, the prevalence in the Indian rural population and in the Indian urban population was shown to be quite low. In a separate study by the 1066 group, which I'll talk in more depth about, there's a higher prevalence in the Indian rural population and in the Indian urban population. In an older study by Chandra and colleagues, it was shown that the Indian rural population had a low prevalence. So basically what you see here is using different definitions of dementia, the prevalence varies. So we really don't know what the accurate dementia prevalence is for South Asians residing in India. Further studies are certainly needed. This is good preliminary work to show that depending on the kind of measurement you're using, you can get largely different prevalence estimates. So let's talk a little bit more about the 1060 group, 6 group study in detail. What they tried to do is they tried to age, gender, and education standardize their data to make it more fair and to make it possible to compare these data across populations. What they did is they found that there were differences in their estimates compared to external estimates due to high false positivity on the 1066 screen. Well, what does that mean? High false positivity means that cases were detected when, in fact, those patients did not have dementia. They also found that there were, in this setting in India, there were a lack of informants to tell the surveyors whether or not the patient had certain kinds of symptoms and diagnoses, whether they would qualify for a diagnosis of dementia. And so many of the informants were suggesting that their symptoms of their family member were just a normal part of aging. So this may be one of the reasons that the 1066 group showed higher rates. What do we really want if we wanted to actually measure how dementia is affecting the South Asian population? What we have already is some prevalence estimates, and that's the number of dementia cases in a defined population at a specific time. But what we would much rather have is incidence data. And why is that? That actually measures the number of new cases in a defined population in a designated time interval. And that kind of gives a person an even playing field to sort of judge different studies. And it's a much better metric and an epidemiology measure to be able to compare populations, to be able to say whether the South Asian population actually has a higher risk of the disease. But unfortunately, at this time, we do not have any incidence studies in the South Asian population in the US. We do have some data about a culture and education fair dementia diagnosis, like I said, the 1066 study, and this slide shows the actual reference, and I would encourage you to read this reference if you're interested. And one thing that this 1066 study that's very nice is it does show us what happens to patients with the diagnosis. They have 3 times higher likelihood of mortality. They have cognitive deterioration over time, as you would expect, and they have an increase in disability. So they follow sort of the normal patterns of what you would expect for people with a diagnosis that was undertaken in other worldwide contexts. These patients also had a progression in their needs for care, which is really important for caregiving, which I'll address in the fourth segment of this module. So what can we actually say about South Asians and their risk of developing dementia here in the United States? What we can say is that we can use risk indices for the South Asian population. And calculating out using a commonly used risk index, we know that South Asians have a lot of the risk factors that predispose a person to dementia. They have high rates of diabetes mellitus type 2. They have high rates of cholesterol. They have low exercise on average, low fish intake, and they can have higher than other groups' levels of depressive symptoms. And so these factors combined help us project that the rates of dementia in South Asians could be up to 2 times that of other groups here in the U.S. If you'd like more details on how South Asians are affected by Alzheimer's and other dementias, I would refer you to the World Alzheimer's Report 2009, where there's a lot of sections that talk in detail about South Asians and dementia and their risk. Thank you so much.